video will provide an introduction to pressure, a physics quantity that shows up throughout a course in introductory astronomy. The creation of pressure is described by the equation pressure equals force divided by area. Thus, pressure is created by a force, think a push or pull, being distributed over an area. For example, the following brick, placed on the tabletop, creates pressure on the tabletop as a function of the weight of the brick. The mass of the brick times the acceleration of gravity creates the force of weight. That force F is distributed over the surface area A of the brick, its width times its height, that is in contact with the tabletop. If the brick were made out of a more dense substance, such as lead, its weight and the resulting pressure exerted on the tabletop would be greater. Let's explore the pressure equals force divided by area equation in a peer instruction question. A block with dimensions 2 by 4 by 7 inches sits on a tabletop. How should the block be oriented to create the maximum pressure on the tabletop? Please record your vote on a piece of paper and explain your reasoning for choosing this answer. Your instructor will now stop the video. Note that the weight of the block, the acting force, is the same regardless of orientation. So to create the maximum pressure on the tabletop, we want to put the smallest area of the block in contact with the table. Atmospheric pressure, covered more extensively in another video, works in a similar fashion, being created by the weight of the gases above you. This brass bar creates pressure exactly equal to the pressure caused by the weight of the atmosphere, 10.1 newtons per centimeter squared. The atmosphere has a lower density, but extends upward to a much greater altitude, so the weight of the two is the same. Using atmospheric pressure and this square foot rubber sheet, one can lift a stool using atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure pushes down on the sheet and holds it in contact with the chair. No air can leak underneath. So the force exerted by the demonstrator on the handle upward is applied to the stool. The following apparatus, produced by Steve Spangler Science, is a small version of the classic bed of nails and allows one to explore pressure. One can place a balloon in the apparatus and force it down onto one or more nails, four shown here. The balloon doesn't last long from the pressure exerted by the force of the demonstrator pushing down on the surface area of the four nails. If we repeat the demonstration with 60 nails, we can't break the balloon. The force applied is just as big, but it is spread over a larger area, so the pressure on the balloon is smaller. When we get a large number of nails, as in the classic bed of nails, even people can get on top of them without getting hurt. Let's look at a few of the many ways that pressure will show up in astronomy. Pressure shows up in one of NASA's modern propulsion mechanisms known as the solar sail, or sunjammer. It is a thin sail that is spread out in space, and it uses the pressure of sunlight for propulsion. No propellant is needed. The sail simply captures sunlight, and its pressure P applied across the area A of the sail provides a substantial force F. This combined image of Hubble's visual light and Chandra's X-ray light shows the expanding shell from a supernova, an exploding star. The expanding shell of debris exerts pressure upon the surrounding material of the interstellar medium, pushing it around and possibly triggering the formation of new stars. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.